Thank you. Oh, I'm gonna do some work on the hives here today and see what's going on. Give them a little bit of smoke. We got four going now. Whereas if you guys will remember, last year we only had two. These two in the middle, they're the originals from last year. What's going on, girls? And these ones on the far outside edges are splits from this year. So we'll see what everybody's up to. We're probably towards the end of our flow. We're getting towards the end of it. The privet, and well, obviously the clover's done. You guys can't see the pasture, but. Oh, yeah. God, these guys need another box already. Bird comb on top. Oh, full of bees. Full of happy bees. What's going on, girls? All that new white comb. Beautiful. Take a frame or two out here and see if we've got anything capped. I can see some of it's capped, which means, heck, it's almost ready for harvest. What's going on, girls?
I'm gonna get in here real quick.
Oh yeah, nice and heavy. Look at that. I don't know if you guys can see, but we've got tons of nectar. I mean, this thing is just full of nectar. Nectar and bees. Little girls are hard at work. Another full frame of nectar. I just want to see when we start getting into the caps real quick, and I'll set these girls down. My third arm here, my frame holder. Let's see what this next frame looks like. These girls next week will probably be getting another frame or another medium super on top. Full of nectar. Uncapped honey. Oh, and they're starting to cap that frame, so that's good. We'll let these girls back in here. Into their happy place. It's good to see. And just think, a couple weeks ago, these frames were completely new. I'd put a couple in there to help feed them. Gosh, that's heavy. All right, girls. Leave. Holy shit. Door smokes or whatever you want to call it. That is full. Beautiful. Got my queen excluder on there. Ooh, the fur comb. I'll clean up off of that queen excluder here. Pop this loose. Maybe one of these days Jess will be brave enough to come down here with her own bee stuff on and get some better videos.
Hi, girls.
What's going on? Mama should be down here. Watch out, little one. Well, we will see. I couldn't find my frame puller, so it's kind of a pain. Nectar going, some drones, lots of pollen. Mostly nectar on this one, because they're so full up. Like I said, they need another box. Desperately need another box. Come here, girls. But beekeeping is not the cheapest of hobbies. I mean, one of these medium boxes with frames already built, painted, things of that nature runs you about $70, give or take. As you can tell, they're all pretty calm. These bees came from a split from our Arkansas hive. When we moved out from Oklahoma, we were lucky enough to, oh, look at all that brood. Make sure mama's not on here real quick. I'll come show you guys. I don't see her. She's doing her job, though, I'll tell you that. So I don't know. You see all that brown stuff in there? That's capped brood. Even the lighter stuff. So that's capped babies. Drones. A little bit of drone brood, but not much, so that's good. And definitely working it. I'd like to at least lock eyes on mama or a few frames of brood and make sure that they're not getting too honey bound, since they don't have the space that they should have. Oh, there she is. Good. So we'll put this back. They're doing pretty well, it looks like. So that's all I'm gonna really do with this one. Should I go through and look for swarm cells? Probably. I probably should. Stop them from swarming. I guess we'll give this a good inspect. We at least know mama's in there. She looked fat and healthy. So they haven't been eating, biting her down, or they haven't been cutting back her egg laying capability, so that's good. Some drone brood. Plenty of brood. Eggs, larva, that's good, that's good. Drone brood. Seeing any anything I should be too terribly worried about. And this is a pretty in-depth inspection. Normally I would just go through, see some eggs, see some brood, make sure everybody's nice and healthy. Oh shit, there's mama again. Mama, you stay in there. Just seen her walk over. I will probably call it quits after this. Yeah, she's getting ready to lay on that, so that's good. I would have expected to see something here, but I haven't, so that's good. Now I just watched her come over into these other frames. She walked across the wall and come over onto this side, but I'm just gonna start putting these guys back gently. I know mama's in there, I know she's laying, I know she's happy. A little bit longer than I'd like, but next paycheck, the end of the month, I'll get another medium, put that on here just for giggles and see how they do with that. But so far, so good, man. Everything's going really good. They're happy, they're calm. They've got plenty of stores. All right, girls, watch out. Here we come. Get everybody to cruise on down. Same thing on this. Let's see if we can get these guys to cruise down and we'll... Of course, I didn't bring my cleaner with me. Can. Just all part of the process. I'll definitely have to remember my queen excluder cleaner with me, my scraper. Next time. Everybody seems to be doing good. All right, girls. Yeah, look at that. They are just packed on there. Come on. Trying to get them off the... Sure don't listen very well. This side. What happens when you don't have enough room? They're all crammed in the bottom here. Some of you guys are gonna get smushed, unfortunately. There comes the real hard part. Putting this heavy son of a gun back on. Gosh! And unfortunately, I mean, you can't help but squish a couple. Look at them all there in front. All right. Shook them off so I can clean this. Definitely don't want that getting stuck on there. Will they build it back up? Yeah, they'll build it back up. All right, girls, last call. Come on. Last call. Make sure my notch is forward. Push some of them back. Keep in mind, any of you guys that do watch this, I'm not a professional by any means. This is technically my one and a half year, maybe. I think that's where I'm at. So normally I'd move down the line and, you know, just go through here and see what's going on, but this is the one I do want to check. So she was, had some swarm cells in it the other day, and I couldn't tell of any queen in there. We've been having a hard time getting this one queened up, or queen right, as you will. So we'll check this one real quick. And this one's tough because I don't have a queen excluder in it. Been trying for the last couple months. They'll make a queen. I don't think the last one got bred. And I could tell that by just a bunch of drone brood, just a bunch of drone brood. And wasn't seeming to do very well, so take a look. Let them know we're coming. So, girls. And they can get a little grumpy when they don't have a queen. They get a little confused. But so far, so good. Not as packed as the other hive. Ooh, look at all them hive beetles. Yeah. Buggers. Get those nasty buggers out of here. I wouldn't call this a weak hive, but I would definitely say it's not my strongest. I mean, there's bees all the way up in here into the middle, and they've got some capped honey and such. Which reminds me, last time I had seen cells up here that I'll double check. Normally they would push your queen down, from my understanding, but I have yet to see that or see her pushed down. Got a young drone up here cruising around, so see there's still that white on there. That's actually capped honey, so they're still working on drawing this frame out. God, hive beetles. I've never seen them like this. But it's probably because it's not a very, like I said, not as strong a hive as my others. Some capped honey over there. I think these next couple frames here in the middle. Couldn't quite catch him, but there's a brand new drone just out of its cocoon over here. I'm not quite where I can work without any gloves on. I mean, this has all been a big trial and error kind of thing. We, oh God, this is heavy. Just kind of learning as we go. Drone cells. Capped honey. Wee. Hive beetle. Capped honey. Let's take out one more frame and see what we've got. It is cute to see a little baby bee. Yeah, that's all. All that is capped. Really got to inspect this one, because like I said, I don't have a queen excluder in here. She could be anywhere if she is in here. I'm expecting though that if anything, I've got one that's just hatched. Capped honey. Can't tell if that's a queen cell or a drone cell, but lots of young drone. Watch out, little dude. I don't want to squeeze you. Even though you're just a freeloader. I'm going to just scoot this one frame over. I've seen it's just capped honey on that side. And let's see what we got here. Yeah. More partially capped. Capped honey and partially capped honey. So, worst case scenario, you know, this hive doesn't requeen. Heck, I've got, like I said, I've doubled my hives this year, so you're expected to lose one or two, I'm assuming. Nobody's perfect, especially with trial and error. Oh, man, you're heavy. You are heavy. Sorry, girl. Let's see what we got in here. It's pretty empty. Not a lot going on. Bees wise. Doesn't surprise me though, like I said, she's been pretty queenless for a while, so it's not a big population of bees. What I might do today, worst case scenario, is add some population to it today by taking out this would have been my Oklahoma hive. So this is one of the originals that come with us 2 years ago. And that on the end is what split off of this, and it's blowing up like crazy. Oklahoma hive, I noticed, a little bit more aggressive than the other Arkansas, but less mites, full of nectar. Not surprised to see some empty frames. Since the new bees are pretty much what are making our beeswax. Well, they're trying. But they're doing their jobs. Hopefully, all I want to do is see her. See her, see some eggs maybe, but like I said, I don't expect to. Lots of nectar. Lots of nectar. Seeing some drone cells, yeah, getting a little spicy now, huh? Ooh, an open queen cell, so somebody just hatched recently. Queen cups.
So, as I get in your way, so these long things here on the bottom, those are little queen cups. See, they look like peanuts. Peanuts there, those are queen cups. Swarm cells, supersedure cells. These ones, there's a larva in that one. There's a larva in that one, larva in that one. So they're getting ready to make new queens irregardless.
Before I clip those off, I want to make sure I see somebody. Like I said, I know that they're trying to make one because they don't have one, but if I can find one in here and she's laying eggs, I'll get rid of those and reduce the risk of swarming. As light as this hive is, I don't foresee swarming, but you leave those queen cells in there, I bet you they will. Pollen, nectar, new drones. I wish I could show you the baby drones. They're real fuzzy. Real fuzzy. They're not the prettiest thing in the world, don't get me wrong. But they are different. Show me some eggs, guys. Show me some eggs. Show me some larva. Show me something. Show me she's home. Nectar, partially made wax. So here's the thing. I've seen larva, so I know there's a queen in here, but my problem is it's all been droned, indicating that she hasn't bred. Which is why they'd be trying so hard to make these new queens. So I'm looking for larva. It's not drone. And sorry, this is a pretty long video. I'll try to keep them short in the future, but it's all part of learning, experimenting. Another queen cell. Probably get rid of that one now just because it's not in a place I want to have to remember to come back to. Sorry, little bee. And the other thing is, I could just get rid of, if I do find her, and I'm not finding any anything other than drone brood, I can get rid of her. Then again, I run the risk of her just being fresh out, because like I said, I saw one that was on there, so a lot of second guessing going on. It's what we call the school of hard knocks. Plenty of honey though, plenty of honey. This will probably end up having a weak hive or something I can supplement the feed, possibly harvest off of this year. We'll go down in here into the bottom. Wasn't this one. So I'll put that checkerboard in some of these empty frames. All right.
check this bottom one. Deep. See if we're rolling into deep. That was a dad joke. That was a bad dad joke. Oh yeah, nowhere near as heavy. Kind of full. Not as full as I'd like to see it this time of year, but let's see what we got. Could have been a bad one. Wow, yep, there she is. She's in there. So, she looks fat and happy. And that's not enough for me, old girl. I've got to see.
That would have been really bad. Could you imagine dropping that? Where the hell did you go? There she is. All right. Every time when you think you don't need something, I end up needing it. All right, so she's in there. I'm gonna put her down here in the shade. While we finish inspecting this. I saw her drop an egg, so I'm kind of curious. Moved over. Goes to show you, you need to have everything, even if you don't think you need it.
fault. I should have had that.
I'll try to show you guys with the queen in there if I can. So I've got the queen sitting over here on the side. I mean, queen catcher. Hoping for some regular capped brood. Just hoping. So there is a queen. Like I said though, I don't know if she's bred. Empty frame. They haven't built up yet. Yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna end up trading out some frames. From that hive down there, because I know she's got plenty of room to spare. Frame. We're just shaking them off. They're not hurting them or anything. I'm going to chance it. I'm going to put her back in there and see what happens. I mean, they're ready to go. They got tons of pollen. They've got some room in here for her to lay eggs if she wants to. Like I said, she might just be sterile. Is a shame. Well, this out of the way real quick.
Gonna steal some frames from here, hopefully. Move them over to that one. Don't necessarily need eggs, but I do need cap larva. And this hive was doing really well. Oh yeah. Of a gun. Holy shiitake mushrooms. That is heavier than sin. Whew. That'll get harvested. I don't even have to look at that. Dad might say, hey, you're not smoking them down. Honestly, I'm trying not to push them down. This I will smoke. Ah. Whew. I think I booked a little bit when I lifted that one. Whew. That's the other thing. These things can get heavy. Heavy. All right, Mama, wherever you're at. Let's see. Heavy. I guess that's cool, honey.
Rolled a bunch of these, that's never good.
But I don't see Mama here. That's good. Probably because I just rolled her off down there somewheres. Like I said, am I doing everything right? Probably not. But we learn as we go. That's got some newer stuff in it. Some cat brood.
want the other one. I think I want this next frame. This has got brood on it, but it's also got fairly newer stuff on it. She could have been here the last couple of days. Oh, there's Mama. That would make sense why. Let's see if we can find a different frame. Leave her alone on there. Keep saying that. But that also means I don't have to go through this one anymore. Leave Mama alone. Yeah, that's a full frame. Both sides. We'll call that good. I don't even know if this video is still going, but cat brood, both sides. Said, well, that these guys have that. Two frames of bees in there. Checkerboard this up. Let Mama do her thing. They're full, they're happy. Let everybody get back to it. Oh, now I gotta lift this one. Oh, there's bees. God. Mother of mercy. Oh. Need to start stretching. That was no joke. So they have some new brood. they have a couple queen cells, maybe a queen. I don't know if she's bred. That's why, like I said, we're gonna leave. I have to remember that. I have to remember that I put stuff in there. So. And that's my Old Faithful. I know that one's doing good, so. That last hive kicked my butt. Heck, I don't even know if we're still filming.
For all I know, we could be timed out.
Huh, look at that. Well, what the heck, since we're here, might as well pop it. For an hour-long video, or who knows how long. Hopefully get to edit this down. Holy. I'm only 37 then. That should not have been that heavy for me. It's the original Arkansas hive. So the one that we've used to split that first batch from. Okay. Yeah. We're doing good. We're working away. Building some comb. Good pipe needle. Not as prolific as either of the short hives, but keep in mind they're brand new. They only got a medium on them. These guys got two mediums. So these guys have been working two boxes instead of one. Still very full. And they're working this too. Cool. Cute. Sweet tea. I wonder if you can go live. Interesting. That's not as full as I would have expected it to be. Very interesting. Let's see what's going on. Good, they're working this new frame with the nectar. That's good. I love seeing that nectar. Some cat brood, mostly nectar. Some cat brood, mostly nectar. Almost like they're getting honey bound. Anyway. look, for a small little town, our city department sure is awesome. They do a lot of work. Cat brood, open frames, so that's good. Or open cells, so that's good. Doesn't look like she's made it over here yet. Watched her walk across the top, so we'll let her do her thing. I'll maybe just check a couple more of these frames just out of curiosity, but I did watch her walk up and over the frame. Yeah, see, there's just so much nectar in these. Got some room over here, but I was definitely hoping for see some more brood. Okay, here's some empty cells she can work. And we've got some over there as well. Okay, so she's got room. She's got room. Got a beginnings of a supersedure cell here. Let's check that out. All right, one more frame and we'll put it back. Coming, so won't sweat the small stuff yet. That's not bad if you ask me. Four out of four hives definitely have a queen. We're just not too sure about that one there. If it's got a queen that's bred or what. This one, they're putting nectar down in the deeps. But she's got something wrong. They've got plenty of room up here. So, we'll see what they do. We'll see what kind of a deal we have going this year. But appreciate you guys hanging out for this. And if you guys have any questions, let us know. I know I still got a bunch of questions. But live and learn, right? If you don't do it, you won't learn. So, all right, guys, I'll go have a drink.